In this illustration, we analyze this electric circuit using Kirchhoff's current law and voltage law. Here, in the circuit shown in figure, we are required to find the current in this resistance R. Again, here I will solve the circuit by using Kirchhoff's current law, for which I can distribute the potential first. So, if I take potential on one side of this resistance as 0, due to this 20 volt battery, potential here will be 20. If here I take potential as x at this junction, it will be x minus 40 due to this 40 volt battery. Now, if I get the value of x, this current in 4 ohm resistance, I can directly write as x minus 0 by 4. So, I can write KCL equation for the potential x, for which I can take sum of all currents going away from this junction, x is equals to 0. The current going in this direction can be written as x minus 0 by 4 plus the current going in this direction as x minus 20 by 2 plus the current going in this direction is further divided in these two branches. Current going here will be x minus 40 minus 0 by 2 plus the current going here is x minus 40 minus 20 divided by 4, that is equal to 0. If we simplify this by taking 4 as LCM, the result is x plus 2x minus 40 plus 2x minus 80 plus x minus 60 is equals to 0. So here it is x, 2x, 3x, 5x, 7x will be, sorry, this is 6x. Here this will be 6x is equals to, we are getting 180. The value of x we are getting is 180 by 6 volt, that is 30 volt. So as we are getting the value of x as 30 volt, current in 4 ohm resistance can be written as 30 by 4, which is 7.5 ampere. That is the answer of this problem. So, dear students, here we are getting the current in this 4 ohm resistance by using Kirchhoff's current law. And once again in this illustration, I request all of you should once again try the same question by using Kirchhoff's voltage law. If you write KVL equations for the distribution of current in the circuit and solve for the current in this resistance R, you will get the same result, but I would like you to solve and verify the result so that you will gain a strength on KVL also. Although you will realize that KCL is certainly a better method because here we are solving the problem by using a single variable x. Whereas in KVL, when you solve this question, you will be getting 3 variables and 3 equations. So it will be quite tedious, but the result finally you will be getting it the same.